Well, the choices are nearly infinite, and the choice you make could be a key to raising a healthy pet.
And that's why we sent News 3's Andy Choi on a mission to find out what's really in your pet food, Andy.
I'm dedicating this one to the news hounds.
Okay, Esty and Lola, listen up.
Yes, veterinarians tell us almost every major pet food manufacturer has announced a recall at some point in time, and with so much variety in the way pet food items are marketed, it takes a detail-oriented pet owner to make the right choice. Their actions move us, tugging our hearts along everywhere they go. It's why if you ever want to know where's Waldo, look for his owner, Kim Amy.
I usually walk him about 2 to 2.5 hours a day. It requires a lot to keep him going. Stay.
Fuel for the 11-month-old lab.
Okay, there you go.
Comes one piece at a time.
If you put his food in a bowl, it's gone in about 10 seconds. So that's part of a weight control thing as well, so that in digestion, because as a lab, he will just gobble his food pretty quickly.
This rubber toy stuffed with food stimulates Waldo's mind while keeping portions under control. But the challenge with food starts long before Waldo takes those first few nibbles.
I think the first thing that I do is look.
Much of Dr. Kem Lambrick's work as a veterinarian focuses on finding the right food for pets.
We all are emotional in the way we feed our pets, but that has to be tempered a little bit with science, and then we're gonna find the right food for every pet, and I think it's different for many pets.
Lambrick says the best pet food should always display one specific label.
The AFCO label is right here, animal feeding tests.
It's from the Association of American Feed Control Officials. The copy should mention a feeding study or say the product meets AFCO levels. Then there's the ingredients, listed in order of their percentage based on weight, with water-rich ingredients often ranking higher.
You see salt, iodized salt? Mm-hmm. Basically, above that, is the major ingredients, and below that is minor ingredients.
Protein should be listed in the product's top three ingredients. Lambrick says the problem with most labels, though, is merely listing the ingredient doesn't tell enough.
On the back, the guaranteed analysis tells us how much protein, but it doesn't say digestible protein.
The challenge in finding information for your pet food is that it can be anywhere on the bag. Take a look at this one. The calorie count is here. The ingredient list is right there. In fact, there are very few laws regulating all of this, and every bag is different.
I definitely think that there needs to be more regulation on that. You know, one pet food looks completely different from another one when you look at the back, and labels can be very deceiving. Marketing is a really high-paying job right now, and there's a reason why.
I don't think that any of these companies are purposely being misleading, but they want to sell pet food. So as consumers, I think this is where the FDA has a very tough job, is we've got to get more information for us.
More than what's in the pet food, Dr. Lambrick says the biggest issue he runs into is animal obesity. He's urging pet owners to keep those calories under control.
I see a lot of people loving them to death, so to speak, because they overfeed them or they feed them a lot of human food.
For pet owners like Amy, managing your pet's diet is tough love that hopefully pays off through the years.
Actually, people think I'm a little crazy with some of the things that I do with his diet, but it will change their lifespan and it will change their whole personality, as well as the way they feel.
Yeah, I should eat my lunch like that. A few notes about grains. That word has been a hot topic in the world of pet food. You may have seen packages boasting a grain-free product. Now, Dr. Lambrick says while corn is often cited as being allergenic, he says according to recent dermatology studies, beef is actually a much more allergenic agent than corn. Frankly, reactions among experts were mixed on the issue of grain versus grain-free food. So really, it's about talking to your veterinarian. Mm-hmm. It's about talking to the people that are involved in your pet's of life and mm-hmm. making an informed decision. But it's like, you know, with our food, we have the FDA and we have that nutritional fact sign. Well, right. There's nothing like that on the bag.
But just like with human food, with pet food, you really have to watch the labels. You really
right.
have to
mm-hmm.
look at the labels.
And it's like, it's a lifelong journey with you and your pet. I mean, yeah. you just don't know until, you know, you feed that to your dog
right,
or your cat.
Don't overfeed them. I mean, that's really
absolutely
important.
Yeah.
And you can find out what if your dog is allergic to things with the blood tests and mm-hmm. there's hyperallergenic food.
And
you're right. It's
and breed-specific food.
That's right.
Yeah, this is just the
tip
of the iceberg.
Raw food.
Yes.
All right, Andy, thanks.
You're welcome.
Thank
Esty and Lola, thank you.